priests of the Congregation of St. Basil the Basilian Fathers. It's my honor to preach today on this celebration in honor of consecrated life and to be in the presence of so many members of various communities of consecrated life. The Dicastery of Institutes of Consecrated Life and Societies of Apostolic Life sent out a message to our communities in regard to the preparation for a Jubilee year in Rome in 2025, saying that the theme of that Jubilee year was very appropriate for members of consecrated life. That theme was Pilgrims of Hope on the Path of Peace. Pilgrims of Hope on the Path of Peace. And it is a very apt description of the meaning of the lives of those who are in consecrated life. We are pilgrims in a particular way. The whole people of God are a pilgrim people. But those who have entered into consecrated life have a particular place in that. From the beginning of formation, in a whole variety of ways that is prescribed in various communities, until the final moments of our earthly life, we are pilgrims. Mine began with my first profession in 1962. I'm grateful to God for the grace of continuing. It is, as a pilgrim people, a commitment to follow Jesus according to the understanding of the founders and the charisms of the various communities. We are pilgrims, and we are pilgrims in hope, both in hope in our communities and also in ministry, a hope that is symbolized in our witness to the good news. Pilgrims of hope on the path of peace. Our call as consecrated persons is to undertake the dynamism of that call to be peacemakers, a way of life that is reconciling one with another in community, with others, and for that matter, all of society as we are sent out to be of service to the church. The universal law of the church, the code of canon law, and canon 573 lists 16 characteristics of consecrated life. It's not because consecrated life is hard to describe, but because it deserves all those various descriptions, because consecrated life exists in such varied forms and varied charisms in those forms, and so to describe it is very challenging. Nonetheless, I think what we heard in the readings today, especially in the gospel, describe what it means to be in consecrated life. Jesus goes to a desert place where he prayed. This is essential to consecrated life, to be persons of prayer, not only for oneself, but especially for the whole of the world and for the church. From the beginning of the formation in consecrated life, we're formed to be persons of prayer. That relationship with the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, which will carry over into our very lives. Secondly, Jesus went out to preach. Persons in consecrated life, by the very fact that they are persons committed in vows, are a witness by their lives. Our very lives are a means of preaching. But then we do that in particular ways, in schools or catechetical programs or in the various ways in which ministry is carried out for the Word of God. And Jesus also drove out demons. Like Jesus, this is done in a prayerful and loving way in the various ministries of persons with consecrated life, whether to the homeless or persons with addictions, families, especially families in which there are challenges, to children in need, in hospitals and clinics, in a whole variety of ways in which we drive out the demons that exist in the world in a prayerful and loving way. And then Jesus, of course, said he had to go to other towns. As religious, we find ourselves on mission, a pilgrim people in hope on the path of peace. And finally, I think the words of St. Paul are worthy of our consideration. He says of himself and every person in consecrated life, we can say, I have become all things to all, to save at least some. Each of us has a particular personality, talents, abilities that allow us to minister to some. And although as consecrated persons, we have been called to become all things to all, as Paul says, each of us hopes and ministers and prays so that we might save at least some.